In this lecture, we will identify the components that should be included in the measurement of the right of use asset on the commencement date. The first component is the initial measurement of the lease liability, which is the present value of the lease payments that are paid after the commencement date. The second component is the lease payments that are paid at or before the commencement date. So, the lease payments are either payments that are made after the commencement date, and these are included in the measurement of the lease liability, and in turn the right of use asset. Or payments that are made at, or before the commencement date, and these are included only in the measurement of the right of use asset. They are not included in the lease liability because they were not paid after the commencement date. We already covered these two components in the previous lecture. The third component is any lease incentives received by the lessee from the lessor on or before the commencement date. In leasing transactions, it is common for the lessor to offer incentives to encourage the potential lessee to sign the lease agreement. These incentives can be, for example, the reimbursement by the lessor of the lease arrangement fees that should be paid by the lessee. If these incentives were received by the lessee on or before the commencement date, then they should be deducted when measuring the right of use asset. But if they were received by the lessee after the commencement date, then they should be considered in the initial measurement of the lease liability, which will then be reflected in the measurement of the right of use asset. The fourth component is any initial direct costs incurred by the lessee to obtain the lease, like, for example, commissions and legal fees. These costs are incremental costs, which means that they are directly related to obtaining the lease agreement. The lessee would not have incurred these costs if the lease had not been obtained. Costs that are not directly related to obtaining the lease arrangement, like, for example, overhead allocations, are not incremental costs, and therefore, are ignored when measuring the right of use asset. The fifth component is an estimate of the costs to be incurred by the lessee in the future at the end of the lease term, for dismantling and removing the underlying asset, and restoring the site on which the leased asset was located, or restoring the underlying asset to the condition required by the terms of the lease. For example, costs to be incurred at the end of lease term to dismantle a nuclear plant that was built on a leased land, and restore the land to its original condition before the lease. The lessee may incur these costs either at the commencement date, or as a consequence of having used the underlying asset during a particular period. The obligations related to these costs are accounted for using IAS 37. These are the components of the right of use asset. Please note that there are some costs that are not included in the right of use asset. These costs are the costs that are paid by the lessee for the construction or the design of the underlying asset. These costs are not part of the right of use asset. Instead, they should be accounted for using the relevant standard, like, for example, IAS 16. Also, the costs that are incurred by the lessee when using the underlying asset to produce inventories during a particular period. These costs are also not part of the right of use asset. Instead, the lessee should account for these costs using IAS 2. Now, let us illustrate with an example. A lessee leases land that it intends to use for its agricultural activities for a lease term of 10 years. The lessee will pay $80,000 annually at the end of each year. The lessor will pay the lessee an amount of $50,000 at the commencement date, as a reimbursement for the costs incurred by the lessee for setting up the land for its operations. The interest rate implicit in the lease is not readily determinable. The lessee's incremental borrowing rate is 6%. The lessee has incurred $30,000 as commission and other legal costs related to the arrangement of the lease agreement. The nature of the lessee's operations requires the use of toxic pesticides to get rid of insects and parasites, and that causes the contamination and poisoning of the land soil. For this reason, the lessee is required by the agreement to restore the land at the end of the lease to its original condition before the inception of the lease. The present value of the total land restoration costs is calculated at the commencement date to be 140,000. Calculate the right of use asset at the commencement date. Let us first calculate the lease liability at the commencement date. The annual lease payment is 80,000. The lessee's incremental borrowing rate, 6%. And the lease term, 10 years. Here is the series of lease payments for the 10 years. Insert the formula for calculating the present value factor for the lease payments. Let us fill the remaining cells with the formula. Now, the present value for each payment. Then the total present value is 588,806, which is the initial measurement of the lease liability on the commencement date. Now, the components of the right of use asset. The first component is the initial measurement of the right of use asset, 588,806, we take it from here. The second component of the right of use asset is the lease payments made on, or before the commencement date. The example mentioned nothing about such payments. So, put zero here. The third component is the lease incentives paid on, or before the commencement date. Here the lessor paid a sum of 50,000 to the lessee as incentives, and this payment is deducted from the right of use asset, so insert 50,000 here with a negative sign. The fourth component is the initial direct costs of 30,000, the commission and other legal costs related to the arrangement of the lease agreement, and they are included here, because they are incremental costs, which means that the lessee would not have incurred these costs if the lease was not obtained. Finally, the restoration costs. And here the example gave us the present value of these costs directly, 140,000. And that's it. The right of use asset at the commencement date is 708,806. The entry to be booked in the lessee's books to record the lease on the commencement date is: debit the right of use asset by 708,806. Debit cash by 50,000, which is the incentive that is reimbursed by the lessor on the commencement date. Credit the lease liability by the amount of the initial measurement, 588,806. Credit cash for 30,000, the initial direct costs paid by the lessee. Credit provisions by 140,000, which is the present value of the restoration costs that will be paid at the end of the lease. That's all about the components of the right of use asset. In the following lecture, we will talk about the components of the lease payments. So, let's move on.